love of the Dons Hall. We are pleased to have you as a part of our audience. We would like to remind you to silence any cell phones or other electronic devices. Also, please note that flash photography is prohibited during the performance. Thank you for your cooperation and enjoy the concert.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Can you hear me clearly? Okay, I'll say just a few words. My name is Winston Choi, and I am the head of the piano program here at Roosevelt University. Thank you for joining on this particular evening. I'm very excited about it. And it's somewhat of a delayed celebration of Beethoven, perhaps originally planned for last year, and now we're presenting it now in 2021. If you haven't already looked through your program booklets, please browse through the remaining events that we have for PianoFest. I'm very excited about tomorrow evening. It's a virtual event with our own piano faculty member, Dr. Wael Farouk, and he's giving a presentation on Egyptian composers, and his own student, Lamis Shams, has a pre-recorded video of a new piece that's going to be also shared during this Zoom presentation. Wednesday evening, we have a concert titled New Music, New Inspirations. So it's essentially piano music that's written within the last few years. Perhaps the oldest piece is about 20 so years old. And includes a work that I myself have arranged from an original composition that I wrote originally for violin and piano. I then did a solo piano version of it, and this will be a two piano version. So I'm splitting this concert with my colleague, Mr. Kwang Hao Huang. And then our final event on Friday evening is three piano concerti for piano and winds. This is with the CCPA Wind Ensemble. Professor Stephen Squire is conducting, and the three soloists are Dr. David Schrader, Professor Adam Neiman, and myself. So we're playing three different concerti by James Lee III, Stravinsky, and Professor Neiman is playing his own wind concerto for piano and winds. So about the program tonight, perhaps it doesn't really need much introduction because these are great masterpieces. But I will say this. No matter how much you hear them, no matter how much time that I personally spend both playing and listening and teaching these pieces, they become greater and greater with time. And there's this sense that these masterpieces provide for us this kind of endless nourishment and inspiration. And so I'll be starting the program with Opus 53. And all I will say is this. As you hear the opening chugging eighth notes as it gets started, it almost suggests the inevitable. Something is about to happen. It's going to usher in all these, a new age of writing, of thinking, of the use of the piano, and it's what a fantastic piece. So thank you for joining. I'll be starting with Opus 53.